Welcome again to this tutorial. In this video, we'll be discussing about a few more processors. So what I have done is I have organized all the processors into a process group. So this is the one, these are the processors which we used in previous lessons. So I have organized all these under data enrichment example process group, and then I renamed that with different name. So now what we will do is we will create another processor group, and here we'll be discussing about a split record, and also we'll be discussing about file duplication and record level duplication. So let me rename it to deduplication example. So if we double click on this process group, we'll be going inside that processor group. So now if you notice, we are inside the duplication example. So again, I'll be reading the same CSV file. So what we'll do is let's go back and copy a couple of processors from previous example. So I'm going to copy get file and update attribute, and also let's copy put file. So I selected these three processors using control shift and then left clicking, and I'm going to go to deduplication example processor group, and here I'm going to press control V. So a simple copy and paste what you do in any other application pretty much. So in get file, we already have our input directory and file filter set, because this is what we just copy pasted from previous lessons. So I'm just going to connect it to update attribute, and the new processor which we are going to learn now is split record. So if you remember, in previous lessons we discussed about partitioning splits the records based on a similarity of the record. So as you remember, in previous tutorial we splitted all the records based on their location ID. In this one, we are going to split all the records based on the count of the record. So what we'll be doing is, let's say there is a scenario and we want to split all the records into set of 50 records per file. So in that case, you can use split record processor. So let's right click on this processor group and click on configure. In the configure, you can see record reader. So record reader, we have already defined the schema, so we are just going to use that, which was CSV reader. So this is same as defined in previous lesson, and we are just going to reuse it. So that's another benefit of using controller services. You can just reuse them again and again. And in the record writer, I'm going to use CSV record set writer. And in the records per split, you need to give the number of records you wanted to split in each flow file. So I'm going to give it count of 100, and let's click on OK and select apply. So once, let me drag this processor, put file processor here. So once split record is successfully able to split the records, we want to load those files to the target directory. So I have connected split record to put file processor, and in this one we have three relations. As you can see, one is splits, and then there are additional relations which is failure and original. So in case of failure, we do not want to do anything, so we will just select here for self termination. And also in case of original, we don't want to do anything, so we'll just select auto termination and click on apply. Note here, I did not select splits, because for the case of splits, we already have a connection set which is pointing to put file processor. So just click on OK. And in the put file, In the properties, if you see, we have already defined directory name in previous file. Let's change this directory to splitted records. And since we have create missing directories option enabled to true, we do not need to set this in advance. This will get auto created. This directory, if it doesn't exist, will get auto created. So let's click on apply. And after that, it is still giving warning, which is related to the relationship, because it expects its relationship to be either self-terminating or it should be pointing to the next process. In our case, we just want to this relationship to be self-terminating. So let's select automatically terminate relationship for both failure and success. Now we can run these processors one by one and see the result. So first one, get file ran successfully, and let's see in the queue. Okay, so as we see in the queue, we have data which came from employee.csv file. And let's now start update attribute. Update attribute is just going to update two attributes, which is input definition and output definition. Let's check them. So for that, you go and click on view details, and then if you see, we will be having input definition and output definition. Input definition is set to input schema, in which we have defined the Avro schema on how to read the CSV file, and similar for output definition, we have defined output schema, and in the output schema we have given the Avro schema format on how to read the schema. Now let's start split record processor and see the result. So now if you see, split record record process splitted the file into 20 flow files, and each of the files should be containing the number of records we given here. So we had given to split 100 records per file. So let's click on right click on this queue and go to list queue, and here we should be able to see the content of the file. So as you see, each of the file having 100 records, and there is one header record. So total we have 101 records, and the same for all the files. So randomly, if I try to see any other, just going to refresh, if we see any other flow file also, the content will be splitted equally. If you had noticed here, we do not have records splitted based on the location ID. If you see, each file having 100 records and it is having mix of location ID, whereas in the partitioning record, in the partitioning record processor, all the flow files had similar record. Now let's run put file. And let's go to view configuration. So we wanted to copy all these files to this directory. We'll go to the server and validate that now. So as you noticed, it has created only one file with the name employee.csv, because as I told you in previous example as well, when this split processor or partition processor works, the file name remains the same. Even though the whole data is split into multiple flow files, the file name remains the same and the unique ID is different. So in this case, what we can do is we can again go back to our previous processor group, and then we can copy this update attributes again and we can reuse that. So now I need to terminate this relationship and I need to connect this to update attribute, and then I'll be connecting it to put file. And in this update attribute, we'll be we'll be updating file name property with the file name and along with location ID. Probably I'll see what is the attribute we want in this case, not necessarily location ID, because we do not have location ID attribute, I think, in this case. So I'll stop it here, and then we will be able to remove this queue. So whenever you want to remove queue, you need to make sure it is not connected to any running processor. So both the processor which is connected to this queue is stopped state, and then you also need to empty the queue, and then only you will be able to see the delete option. Now we'll be connecting this split record to update attribute, and then in case of splits, we want the flow files attributes to be updated. So what we'll do here is, if you remember, we do not have any location ID in this case, because in previous example partition record processor created location ID attribute. In this case we are not using partitioning, so no location ID attribute has been created and attached to any flow file. So what we will do is, if all the flow files has UUID which remains unique, so what we'll do is we'll use that UUID to generate unique file names. So the syntax to use UUID is UUID, and since it is a function, you have to also use parentheses, opening parentheses and closing parentheses. Hopefully it should work. I have not made any spelling mistakes. Let's run this again. I'm just going to stop this get file again, otherwise it will keep on submitting new files which we do not want. And let's right click on this queue and see whether the file name attribute, what is the value in the file name attribute. Okay, this one is employee.csv, because this one is the queue before update attribute processor, so that's why you see the same value. Now after we run update attribute, the file name value should be getting changed. Okay, now let's see in the queue of these processors, and then as you can see here, file name value has been updated. So now we are going to write using put file. Let's start this one. Now if you go to view configuration, you will be seeing that we have directory temp record configured. So inside this we should be able to see our files. Let's verify that on the server. So we are already in split records directory. Let's do ls, and as you can see, there are 20 files which has been created here, and each has been created with UUID appended to the original file name.